Hello. Knock, knock. Who's there? OMG. Life is awesome. For some reason, I'm a lot darker today. I have my light on. I'm not sure. But can you see me enough? Hello! Music a bit louder. There we go. Do that. Okay. Let's see if I can get back in the swing of things. Okay. First order of business. Thank you for the 11-month resub. Almost a year, Riley. How crazy is that? Second, why is my follower count wrong on here? Thank you. Second, you're a bit darker, but it's all right. Yeah, I'm not sure why it is so dark. My light's on. I'm not sure. Anyway, second, I've got a cold. I already tested, I don't have COVID. I just usually get like stress fevers when I go on trips and stuff, which is awesome, but yeah. So I've kind of fully recovered, not physically, I got up and I got dressed. So like, I'm clearly doing better, but you can hear my voice. So that wasn't for sympathy points. That's so that you're like, why are you speaking like that? Yeah. We understand. Cool. Okay. And also, if I have to stop to like catch my breath because talking requires a little bit more effort, then you know why. But I'm about to put myself to the test and do a bunch of speaking right now, so we will see how long I last. And I have my mute button ready just in case I need to cough, because I don't want anyone hearing that, because that's so gross. Okay. Let's say hello to everyone. Oh my god, Mono. Thank you for the 10 months. Thank you. Okay, right. Let's go back and say hello to everyone. Hi, Riley. Hi, Annabelle. Hi, Mono. Hi, Grandma's Cookie Dough. Oh my god, awesome. Hello. Hi, Kaya. Hi, Amy Pond is gone. Hi, Izzy. I almost said Lizzie. That's not what that says. Hi, Izzy. Hi, James. So maybe we got sick from Twitch one. Yeah, I think realistically what it is, other than the obvious being actual viruses spreading, a lot of us aren't used to, maybe I'm just projecting, being around that many people, and so our immune systems kind of suffer. Especially I don't really get out much, so my immune system is like, what? And I get home and I immediately have all of the panic attacks that I had bottled up over the weekend. And I was like, it's so good to be home. I could just cry. But yeah. Hi, Austin. Hello. Hi, Twinkles. Hello. I think that's it, honestly. Yeah. Yeah. And obviously some people who, I think some people know they have COVID and they go, anyways. Or, well, whatever. I don't know. Did you, like, not have fun or something? No, I had the best time. Which is why we're about to stream for 8 hours! I'm kidding. So we can do, all of the story times and all of the most fun. Meebs, you're actually first on the list because your birthday was first. So I wish I'd seen more of you over the weekend. No, literally, it was so, like, hectic, but I think, I'm glad I did get to see you, because I didn't see some... Is it PowerPoint time? It is! It is. I have a... How did you know? That, first of all, that's crazy. I've got a PowerPoint, but I haven't done it how I usually do it, because I want you guys to watch the vlog, but I've got some pictures courtesy of Rosie's amazing Digicam, which if you watched the last vlog, you would see... Oh my god, sorry, that was weird. It wouldn't let me send a message. There you go. If you watched the last vlog, you would see Rosie's cute little Digicam pictures. But yeah, first up, We have. Oh, actually, wait. The first slide is. The first slide. I can make myself bigger, actually. Awesome. The first slide is actually coming up, guys. Coming up on the Smidge's stream. It's such a cute vlog. You should watch it if you haven't. So true, Riley. Everybody should. Okay. First up, we have Meeb's birthday and what we did. Second, we have these kind of like chapter titles. Chapter one, Meeb's birthday. Chapter two, meeting chatters at TwitchCon day one. And then I'll do a haul of everything I bought and everything I was given and free stuff that we found. The escape room fiasco day two, which you'll see in the vlog, but I'm going to talk a bit about. And then what date was Meeb's birthday? The 27th. But yeah, so we were over there for that. We did a little mini celebration before for gifts and stuff, but the actual day we went out and did something which you will see in a second. And then Rosie's magic networking, because I actually have Rosie to thank for everything. And then getting drunk with the Twitch CEO. That's an amazing clickbait. It's not really clickbait, but I just needed some buzzwords for that chapter title. And then performing in a band of strangers with Rosie on a whim, which is technically the same thing, but I just felt like that I needed that number of bullet points. Okay, anyways, moving on. First up, we have Meeb's birthday. I feel like I need a happier song for this. Rosie sees magic. To be fair, I call it magic, but realistically, she just, like, is clever and networks with people and actually keeps in contact. Like, we met people last year, and she actually keeps in contact with people and, like, becomes friends with and whatever. So, she's actually awesome. Give me a good, happy song. There we go. Okay, let me make myself smaller for this one. Look at this. This was Meeb's birthday. This was such a fun, cute day. Look, so we went on a boat ride, and look, okay, ignore my hair in this one, guys. I was wearing a hat the whole day. We don't need to talk about it, but we wore little party hats, and we got the person, controlling the boat, driving the boat to wear little party hats. We're awesome. And here are the cute little pictures that Rosie took. Look at this. Look at this awesome. Oh, you can't see my mouse. Look at this awesome bridge. That's how funsies it is. So this was in Amsterdam. So we traveled up, I don't know, across, whatever. We traveled to Amsterdam for the boat ride. I don't know. Sorry, I'm like glitching. Hello. And it was really fun. It was really cute. We got like some drinks and stuff. We had like Prosecco. I don't like beer, but we had beer. And it was really fun. I ate like basically an entire pint of strawberries, but I had the best time. It's so cute. Like, look at the weather. I don't know if you could tell from these pictures, but the weather was literally perfect every day. Like, I'm telling you, we need to buy a lottery ticket. We're not going to. But it was so good. It was so good. It was so fun. And I'm so glad that Meeb's had a good birthday. If you're still here, please verify, or else I could be lying. You know, I could be lying. But yeah. And so on this boat was me, Meeb's, Rosie, Jude, and Johnny, which is link up of the century. Sorry, I'm never saying that again. But it was fun. We had a lot of fun. We bumped into some other people there, but that was just the people that were on the boat. And there were three Americans on our boat as well. But they were kind of all right. They weren't kind of all right. They were actually all right. They were pretty chill. But I found it quite funny when one of them was like to the driver, honestly, what do you think of American tourists? And there was like a little bit of silence on the boat for a few seconds. We were all like, people. And he said something really clever. He was like, if you're coming to Amsterdam and you're an American, you're one of the all right ones. Like, he was like, the ones I've met that come here seem all right. So I was like, that's a good save, man. Well done. That was pretty good. But yeah, that was really fun. So on this day, we arrived, went back to the hotel. They let us check in early as well. We went to the hotel to like put our bags down, and then we had expected to like go until check in. But they were like, no, your room is ready. And it's like the good luck keeps getting better. Like, it just, like, lottery ticket is needed, but no. And then we like hung out a bit in the hotel room. And then after that, we like went to explore Rotterdam before we went to here. And then we met everyone there and went on a cute little boat ride. It was very sweet. Smidge is back. I am back. And also, because I am back, guys. Okay, I keep getting notifications to use my heart rate monitor. I'm not going to. Because I'm back, guys, I actually am. For realsies. Because I'm going to try and figure out a streaming schedule. Not just like I'm going live at this time. Like, I'm gonna try and pick actual days. I really don't know. I'm like hesitant to say it in case it doesn't happen, because I don't know. It might. Have you bought any new games with the Steam summer sale? There's a Steam sale? Does it happen every year and I'm being stupid? That's awesome. Maybe I should look at some games you guys want me to play now that they're on sale. Are Life is Strange games on Steam? Because then now's probably the time to buy them, right? Is this correct? Probably, right? Because if then, is House Flipper 2 on sale? That's actually what I need to know. Well, for you, let's be honest. I played like 2 streams of House Flipper 1 and I just don't have the attention span for it. That would be cool, but also I understand that it can be hard to hold it. Stream schedule. Yeah, I think also I'm like, oh my God. I think my only fear with having a stream schedule is if I pick certain days and then like a friend wants to hang out or something comes up. I'm sorry, but there's not a universe ever where I'm gonna be like, sorry, I can't hang out, I have to stream. That's embarrassing to me. But then I guess I just would miss it that day. But then I guess what's the point then if I would just stream whenever I want? Do you see what I'm saying? But I don't know. A game called Just Cause 4 DLC, all bundles on sale from £4? What? Okay, I should look. That's so fair, yeah. So, Just Cause is on sale. I'm actually never gonna speak to Meebs ever again because they're just gonna go and play every game. I hope you have the most fun ever, and please report back what games you play, Meebs, and what you do. Have the most fun ever. Bye. I'm kidding. Okay, but yeah, this is cute. You'll get more. Actually, wait, first of all, I was gonna say you'll get more of these pictures on my Instagram, but I'm actually late to the party. I haven't posted them yet. Meebs and Rosie have both posted some of the cute pictures already, so go check out their Instagrams to see them. But I'm gonna post some probably later today, but yeah, they're really cute. Okay. Now I go back to just chatting because I'm just going to go through my notes now. Okay, cool. Hopefully you guys can last without having photos, but it's because I've got physical stuff to show you as well. My dad bought me Stray, Inside, and Limbo. Oh, maybe I should try Inside. And I bought my dad a game off his wishes for like 33% off. You should definitely have a look. Oh my God. Also, by the way, guys, I was telling my dad about... I don't know if I already told you this. I was telling my dad about Life is Strange. I actually don't know what reason. And he was like, wait, what's this game? And I started telling him about it, and he was like, wait, why have you never mentioned this to me before? You've never told me about this game. And I was like, sorry, I don't know. I haven't mentioned it. I don't know. I just thought, I don't tell you about games often. He was like, why didn't you tell me? This is like everything I want to play this game now. It's got time travel and lesbians. Why would I not want to play it? And I was like, okay, I can set it up on your PC if you want to. So I might report back when Dad finishes Life is Strange, and I want to see what thing. But the thing is, I also, maybe I stream with him playing it. I don't know. I think he kind of wants to just play it on his own. But I think that would be so awesome. Because like, after that conversation, he would keep going, wait, so tell me about the powers she has again. How does it work? And I'm like, wow, you really are into this. Maybe I should, that's so cute, I know. That's so cute, actually coughs up lungs. No, I'm kidding. Mrs. Midge being base as always. I was telling him about, we'll get onto this, but I was telling him about, the people I met at TwitchCon, and he was like, did anyone ask where Mr. Smidge was? And I was like, no, and he went, so there you go, guys, you know what to do next time. I'm kidding. Okay, right. Oh, it's the haul time. All things I brought is the top number one. Okay, I'll show you my, my lanyard. So this is my lanyard. It's got Smidge's affiliate. Next year it's gonna say partner. No, it won't. Well, we can only hope. That's the goal. Anyways, it's signed by my two favorite people in the world, Meebs and Rosie. If you can't tell, that's Rosie's signature. Guys, don't steal it. It's got two love hearts, and Meebs has a smiley face. And then here's everything. I actually can't wait to, like, start integrating these into outfits and stuff. Okay, right. So, key rings. We have this little guy. Can you see? Oh my god, bro. Him. Can you see it? I'm dying. He's cute. He's got a little star. I saw those. They're so cute, literally. Ah. Okay. Little shark. Which, I'm not sure if this is actually Foolish March. If it is, cool. If it's not, cool. It's a shark with a six pack. Maybe it's not. I don't know. Maybe it is. But I bought it because it's cute. I was actually a menace. This was on the second day, actually. I spent so much money, but we'll get there. I don't think it is. Okay, then awesome. Here are all my badges. I'll walk you through it. Okay. We have a snorkeling rabbit. This is free. It's this, you know, the Pando bot? Akko has it on his stream. Do you know what I mean? They're like the little creature that says hi to people. They have another bit of the bot where, like, kind of like it's kind of like words on stream. Well, like, it's not, but like, it's one of those things that, like, chat can talk to while you're not there. So I might use it in the future. It's really cute. This was free. It's the Opera GX waifu lady. Yeah, I can't believe I just said that word. Anyway, it's her. Because, and I'll tell you how I got this in this TwitchCon day two list, okay? Guys, I'm doing so well forming sentences. Little clown. I was struggling there. I'm not sure what this is, but it's cute, whatever it is. It's like a person, little creature thing, little person with stars and everything. It's just so me, so I bought it, basically. I don't even think there was a sale on badges or anything. I just got them all. But do you know what? Like, I can make money back. I can't ever get this again because I haven't been there. What? Because I can't go back. Oh my god, guys, please help me. I'm just gonna have to work extra hard this month, basically. But I kind of saw that coming. Anyways, I can do it. This badge is so cute. And it matches the thing. Thank you, Ivy, for the follow. It's a muscly rabbit. This is me, guys, by the way. This is what I look like. This is Happy, Happy, Happy Cat. Can we see him? Where is he? The Woo cat. I think it's Woo, is it not? It's Woo, right? I think it is. Anyways. Yeah, look at him! Oh my god, wait. That's awesome. I got this little guy. It's a crying frog. OMG, I saw that and said to Spuddy, that's so Smidge. Yes! And then there's this little thing. It says friend. No, it doesn't. Does it? No. Oh my god, it's a Tamagotchi. I'm stupid. I was like, that doesn't say friend. That says Tamagotchi. Yeah, because it's a Tamagotchi. Wow. How did I not realize? I didn't know what it was. I just bought it because it was cute. Wait, that's such a good idea. That's so cute. A badge that looks like a Tamagotchi. Okay, those are all my badges. Cute. And key rings. Okay. Love it. All things I bought. Okay. Is there any bought things in here? Yes, there is one. So with this one, I might ask if we can trade, but also it's not that big of a deal. But also, maybe it's fine. I don't know. But I found these. There was one left of the rabbit one. And so I like bought the last one. It was like, I don't know, fate or something. But I kept like, okay, not even over the weekend. Whenever the three of us see the three of anything, we go, oh my God, it's so us. But there was a blue, pink and green animal keychain with like butterfly wings, which is our colors. If you haven't noticed, I've like shifted from purple to I shifted from like purple to blue in my branding, but anyways, and we were like, wait, that's actually us. So I bought them. But it's really cute. So Rosie has the pink butterfly wings with the rabbit. And then Meebs, is yours a deer? I can't remember. But they have the green wings. And then mine is blue. And it's a little cat, which is very cute. And it has the clasp too. It's really cute. Yippee! If you can't tell, I love acrylic keychains, like, so much. Okay. So, now I'm going to... Which, by the way, journal update, look at it. It was, like, basically empty the last time you saw it, I think. A lot of these stickers are from Meebs, and then the rest are from, like, albums and trades. But also it's starting to beef up. Okay. What can I? Oh my god. Oh no. Guys, I forgot to tell you. Okay, so I walk past this nerd shop and I'm like, they've got to have Doctor Who stuff in here. Let's go in. I'm looking around, can't find anything Doctor Who, which by the way is frankly annoying. If I go into a shop and you've got Star Wars and anime stuff and Harry Potter stuff, I'm expecting Doctor Who stuff to be there as well. Like, don't piss me off. Anyway, so we go in and I can't find anything. And then Rosie points out these cards. And I'm like, oh my god, Doctor Who cards, this is perfect, I'll buy it. And then I realize, oh, they're Magic the Gathering cards, I don't want it. So I put them back, because I don't play Magic the Gathering, I don't know what it is. Well, yeah, I know what it is, but I don't play it. So I put it back. And then I find this cinnamon roll nightlight blind box. Buzzword, buzzword, buzzword. So I buy it. Like 14 euros, whatever. Actually, I think it was like 12. Still, it was too much money. But then as I was waiting to pay for it, I was like, wait, but I want something else. I want something Doctor Who. And I go, do you know what? I'm just gonna buy the cards because why not? Okay. But I'm really stupid. I just didn't think that cards could be expensive. I don't know, guys. I know you're like, what are you talking about? Like, hello? Yes, of course they're expensive. Like, I know. And I was too awkward to put them back or like go, oh, actually, I didn't look at how much they were. I'm never mind. I'm not buying them anymore. And I was just like, fine. I'll just buy them. Guys, they were 29 whole euros. I spent like 40 euros in that shop. No, actually more. It was like 50 altogether. So there's that. Let me show them to you. Do I even have them in here? Oh my god, I do. Is Spuddy still... Oh, yeah. Yeah, 29.95 euros. But let me tell you, they're actually so worth... They're not. They're bits of cardboard. But they're so cool. Okay, guys, gather around. James, jingle jangle. You're going to want to see this. Okay, first card, Death in Heaven. Crazy, like, my expectations were so low for these. I didn't realize that Magic the Gathering cards were actually sick. Okay. First card is Death in Heaven, which is an episode card. It's a holographic. Susan Foreman. I've got the Doctor's granddaughter. I can't stay long, but it was so cool meeting you. Hi! Were you here already or not? Because I literally just summoned you. Did you just get here? That was really weird. I literally just said your name. Okay. I got Susan. Just joined. Oh my god, that's crazy. Because I've used all your stickers. Every single one. Oh my god, look at this card. Grasp of Fate. And the quote for this card is, and I suppose if it's one last chance to say it, Rose Tyler. And then look at the... And it's holographic. Bruh! I got Nardole, which is so funny. Blasphemous Act, which is the master, spoilers. Dalek Squadron, which is just a plain, boring card. Mountain, okay. The Fourth Doctor, would you like a jelly, baby? Look at him. Shiny Adipose. I want him for real. I want him to be real. Last night together. Guys, it's Deryllium. The towers sang and you cried. River Song. Such a pretty card. Got Rassilon, which by the way is like a plain boring card. Who cares? Irrelevant. Stormcarved Coast, which is from the Rebel Flesh episodes, which is holographic as well. Temple of Deceit, Game Station, Satellite 5. I got to go switch. Hope you have a great stream. By the way, you're really pretty. Thank you, Izzy. Thank you. Thank you for stopping by. I got Rose Tyler. Not many can say that. I guess many can. I don't know. The Seventh Doctor. Cool. Those are all the cards. They smell really good, by the way. I don't know if that's weird, but you know when you, a book has a good book smell? They have good book smell. But cool. I'm keeping them in here for now. And then they will eventually actually go in top loaders, which is crazy that I'm even saying that. But like, I have them, so why would I not use them? Okay. But that's what we did even before we got to TwitchCon. That was the day before. Okay. So this was my day one page. So in here we have Rusty Lake, which is a game I actually want to play. It's from a game dev that Rosie really likes. They're like her favorite game company ever, and they were there, and it was so cute because she was so excited. Like, she walked past, yeah, your card. She walked past and she was like, oh my god, would just start fangirling, and I was like, oh my god, do you recognize the girl like at the front of the desk? And she was like, no, it's my favorite company. And I was like, oh my god, that's so funny. But yeah, no, it was so cute. And we kept going back, and you'll see why in a second. And I've got this little like thing that's got all the business cards that I like to keep. This was also from the Rusty Lake people. It's this cute little ticket. These are coins that Riley gave me. I didn't actually realize you were going to give me money, but I have. Also, it's really funny. I thought you gave me British currency. I didn't realize that our coins are so similar. Like, you literally have the Queen on here. That's what we get for being horrible, I guess. But you have British Queen on your coins. But they are Australian. What are they? Cents? 18 months! Wait, I've had two babies? Oh my god. That's crazy. Hello. Whoa! Oh my god. I went too far. Okay. It's Aussie. But it's... It's so little. It didn't really matter. 20 cents, 50, and a dollar. Wait, you gave me... $1... 70. Wow. And then in the corner, hi, in the corner is Riley's note. I'm not going to read it, but it was really sweet. And yeah, your journal looks so cool.
Thank you.
It's not even a pound. Oh my god, is the conversion that much? That's crazy. Okay, I'm turning the page now. So this was, this is the same day. This is basically Spuddy's page. So Spuddy gave me all these stickers, minus a few of them are from a different sticker sheet. And then this is a drawing of me that Spuddy did. And then this is Spuddy's note, which I stuck upside down by accident. But yeah, look, it Sims me, guys, actual fame. The Adventure Time ones, I know, right? They're so cute. I love the fact that you did a blurb sticker. Okay, I'm going to cover the writing. How do I do this? Actually, it will be blurry if I just hold it that way. Okay, you can see all of the Doctor Who stickers. We have 10, 11, 12 with the glasses. And then me! It's me as the Doctor, guys! And then there's a bunch of... This is Le Seraphim and Luna. There's a Dalek, there's a, Cyberman. Are you my mummy? The Ood and the TARDIS. Awesome. And on my phone case, you can't see because it's underneath, but I have two. I'm just going to show you. How do I show you without showing you my bank card? How do I do this? Get out. This is on my phone now. The two little rabbits. Although this one keeps moving because my phone heats up so much that it like has melted it a little bit, but it stays in my phone case, so it shouldn't come off. Yeah, that was awesome. Okay. So, please don't do that. Oh my god, please don't peel it. My phone case is so yellow. Okay, if I do this, it should be fine. Yep, fixed it, life is good. Okay. Spuddy also made stickers for Meebs for their birthday, which I thought was really cute. It's a bunch of like fish related stuff, ocean things. I didn't do a journal page for the second day because, I mean, you'll see, the second day is pretty hectic. I mean, you won't see because I'm going to talk about it, but the second page, this page of notes is hot, is like this long. The second page is two columns. Okay, so continuing on with everything I bought, because that's basically all that we did the first day. pretty much. I mean, we also hung out and had fun, but like, what I'm talking about stuff to show you. And if you guys want some awesome stickers, yes, I was gonna say they're waterproof and you can move them around. Like, if anyone else gets like sticker anxiety, like you put it down, you're like, fuck, I can't move it. Or like, what if I don't want to put it down in case I can't move it. But I like, even on the paper, I could like, I on my journal, I could like take them off and replace them. So, and I think the fact that they're handmade are really cute. Okay. Here are the stick. I've already used some, but here are the sticker sheets that I got. I love people who do sticker sheets at cons, or sticker bundles as opposed to singular ones. But Under the Sea, it's a rabbit under the sea. Gardening, it's a rabbit gardening. And Moments Outside, it's... I gotta go, everyone. Bye-bye. It's a rabbit camping outside. So overall, these three are very cute. Oh, it has by M-A-I-I-N-I. Very cute. And also this one. Garden sticker sheet. Very cute. Okay. Shall I continue with the rest of the gifts now, since I already basically showed you in the journal? Yes, is the answer. Okay. So, also, I don't want to show you yet. I'm hiding it. So, anyway, So a few people came up to me. The only thing is, it's good that TwitchCon has badges, but I know it's crazy to say this, but for next time, I would love it if people would just show me their badge first or tell me their username first, because obviously I don't recognize people's faces unless I already know who you are, which is parasocial. But anyways, so there were some people talking to me who came up to me and then they showed me their badges and I was like, oh, okay, hello. And everyone was so lovely, and it's obviously really nice to hear, people being nice in person, because obviously you see nice comments and you're like, oh, that's nice, and that's still, like, it's heartwarming and everything, but it does feel a little bit different to, hear people be like, obviously everyone was talking about SBS, so that kind of made me, like, go, oh, maybe I should actually, like, pick that up again. It's just, it's very expensive, obviously, and that's why it's kind of been a bit slow this time. But I don't know. I'm gonna pick it back up again and see if... I'm just gonna say this now. It's not gonna happen, but maybe I shouldn't say it's not gonna happen because then it's not gonna happen. But I'm just gonna say this now that I would love to have at least the first episode out by my birthday. Which, is 7 weeks away. And if you knew where I was currently with it, you'd be like, are you insane? So we'll basically just see. I'm gonna aim for it. And if I don't get it, it's fine, because I would have made significant progress anyways. That's the plan. I just don't want to release it. I don't want it to take as the same amount of time as last year, basically. Like, because I essentially started SBS 2. Okay, I'm gonna be honest. I started SBS 2 last April, which is almost exactly the same time. No, March. Which is almost exactly the same time as I started SBS 1. And SBS 1 was released the following February. So, or the end of January even. So I'm really hoping, like, you should get SBS 2 in the next few months. And the way that I'm doing it is, I think I had told you before that there's something about it that's going to be different. the something about it, I'm gonna still be vague, but the something about it that was gonna be different was the amount of people. And although that's not changed, and this actually could, I could retract my statement depending on what happens. But I'm going to stick to my original plan because it will be faster. And not in like a rushing way, as in like, that was a bit too ambitious. Do you know what I'm saying? And there's nothing wrong with doing the same amount as last season. Or maybe I'll do the same plus one. Or maybe I'll do the same. Basically, I'm just gonna see. I'm gonna like fill up the original slots. Finished. And see where I'm at. And if I can be like, oh my god, I can do another one. Then I'll do another one. Or another X amount. Do you see what I'm saying? I just got back from my week trip in Italy. Oh my god, hope you had the most fun ever. Hello. Welcome back. But yeah. Anyway, sorry, back to what I was saying. There was a bunch of people coming up to me, talking to me about SBS, and a lot of the things people talk to me about is SBS and my outfits. So it's quite, it's kind of like a in-person survey, because it's like, that's what I'm known for. Like people, the most things people talk to me about are fashion and SBS. So I was like, interesting. That's what people know me for. I don't know, that was just like fun to know. I don't know if I ever doubted that, but like, I don't know, it's like recognition in that area, do you know what I mean? Then while I was talking to these people, Hiccup stopped me, and so I got to meet Hiccup, which was cool. And I signed people's stuff. I bet I don't do that often at all, really, and I got to sign things. I will say though, I'm really sorry. Okay, guys, I should have given you more cards. I should have given you more cards because I have so many left over. But I think what I'll do is for the, whenever I do SmidgeCon, I'll give away a bunch in like the Gacha machine. It will be like $2 dono or $5 maybe, I don't know if it's a fundraiser for SBS, and you get to take a chance to get one and they'll all be signed or something. But yeah, second thing, I was going to sign them if people wanted to. Okay, basically I've learned things and I'm really annoyed that I learned this lesson and we have to wait a whole year now for it to happen again, for me to see you guys again, unless you guys all come to Comic-Con in October, which I might go to. I doubt, Riley, you're gonna fly back over, but whatever. But what I noticed is that I have responsibility in the moment, meeting a viewer, that I can't be, like, yeah, I'm gonna be nervous, but you're gonna be nervous as well. And so it's kind of my responsibility to be the person who's like chill. And I've kind of realized that, cause it's not in my nature at all to be like, oh my God, hi, do you want a picture? Do you want a photo? Do you want me to sign anything of yours? Like that's so unlike me. Like I would rather have a conversation, but that's not, yeah, it's absolutely fine for people to want those things. But the thing is, I didn't realize I should offer it. Like I completely forgot that the other way around, it's really awkward to ask, hey, can you sign this or whatever? So I've now learned that if someone meets me and like they're a fan or whatever, I'm supposed to be like, oh my God, do you want to take a picture with me? Do you want me to sign this? Do you want a card, etc. So I've learned that, guys, but I'm really sorry that I had to learn it through you guys. And so you didn't get signed cards, but you did get a card. So, yeah, I won't be over in October. I will be in November/December. Oh my God, wait, you're still going back? That's awesome. But yeah, so, but still, it was really great. I had a really like positive time meeting people. There was no awkward encounters. The only thing is the second day, I'm not sure if you're here. There was someone who, or two people, was it? Who bumped into me, they like stopped me while I was rushing somewhere, and I felt, well, I mean, I was going somewhere, so like whatever. But I just hope you don't think, I hope it didn't come across as rude or anything. I mean, actually, they were really nice. They were like, it's okay. And I was just like, sorry. We were just trying really hard to get this escape room thing, which you'll see in the day two thing. I'll probably be going to Comic-Con in October. Oh my God, this is awesome. And before I move on, what I will say, and this is really fun. No, I actually can't say that. Well, now I have to, because now I've said that. Okay. I was like, I was like, oh my God, I'm gonna go to Comic-Con with Dad, of course, because he likes Doctor Who and Star Wars, and it's the perfect place to find Doctor Who and Star Wars stuff. But he keeps saying that I need to go to Comic-Con on my own, or else I'm never going to find a girlfriend, which is crazy to say. But okay, Dad. Hello? But anyways, continuing on, everyone was lovely, and it was awesome. Nothing much else to say, okay? The other things that I received, I feel like I need a good song for this. I actually can't. I don't know how to properly show this off. Like, I don't know how to... Guys, take a look at this. I want you to look at it first before I explain what it is. Wait, let me get this right. It wasn't you, was it? I don't think so. I don't want to get it the wrong way around. Oh my God. Oh my God, no, it is you. It is you. It was you. Oh my God. Sorry, I get you too confused. No. Riley made this for me. Buddy did the other thing, I remember now. Are you, look at this, it's crochet. I created it from scratch, including the pattern. You should sell these. Sell these to these guys, the smidge plushie. I do! Guys, buy them! Buy them now! Go to Riley's Twitter account and buy them right now. Look at this. This is crazy. It's so cute. He's full of soup! He's full of soup! He's full of soup, guys. It's so cute. And even better... James, are you locked in? Are you ready for this? Are you ready? Long chain. Look at this, man. look at it, it tells a, this is a real clock. Spuddy got me this. For those of you who don't know, this is the Doctor Who fob watch that the Doctor uses across a varying amount of episodes across different eras, in which a Time Lord can use a chameleon arch where they put this fob watch in this like head thing, and it turns them into a human or a different species or whatever, and then their identity is hidden inside the watch, and then when you open it you become the Time Lord again. And little fun fact on the front of this, this is actually the Gallifreyan solar system, star system. How awesome. And then on the back, it's just got some like leaves and stuff, which is cute. But yeah, it actually tells the time, but what's interesting about that is one, I can't read Roman numerals, and two, I can't read a clock. So, but, you know, maybe I will learn. Yeah, I missed that class at school. Well, no, I can read a clock. It's just, it takes me a lot of time. Like, I have to, like, I can't look at it and know the time. I have to, like, work it out. Which I guess is still better than nothing, so whatever. There we go. Awesome. When I got given this, I literally almost cried. Actually, no, I did. Well, my eyes teared up. No, nothing flowed out of my eyes. Why the fluff was so sweet? This is crazy. This is what I'm saying. And I was actually telling my dad that I'm glad it was you guys that were the first group of people that I properly like met at conventions, because you're all like normal. Well, okay, you know what I mean when I say normal. Like, you're not normal, but you're not like you're like, you're, you guys are like the dream chatters. You're like the, you're, you guys are like what every streamer wants their chat to be like. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's so nice because you're so easy to talk to. And like, hello, you got me a fob watch and you made me this. Like, you're just people with interests. And what it is as well is you remind me of me when I was, okay, wait, that sounds patronizing. That's not what I mean. What I mean is like, you know how I'm a fan of Doctor Who? Maybe that's too intense. You know how I'm a fan of XYZ? You guys are like that. Like, you're a fan in the same way as me. Do you know what I'm saying? Switch to school as an artistic. Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying? So you're not like weirdos. That's what I mean. Like, you might be strange, but you're not weirdos. Yeah, basically. Okay, so that's that. But we are, so they aren't wrong. Yeah, exactly. Okay, on to the rest of the stuff that I bought. All my prints and stuff are in here. And also free stuff. Okay, are we ready for this rapid fire? Because we've hit an hour now. Actually, no, maybe we don't need to rapid fire. What we do need to do is retweet my tweet soon. We all just understand fandom culture, yeah. I feel like quite a lot of you have been in other fandoms before as well. So it's, and no ages, obviously, but it's evident in the people I meet that you're not super young, which I would hate. No offense. Like, I can tell that quite a lot of you have grown up on the internet and been like, this isn't your first fandom, which is brilliant because it means nobody has to teach you etiquette or anything. We're all adults. Yeah, basically. Fig, oh my god, almost like ruined my voice doing that. Hello guys, Fig makes an appearance in the vlog. So, you're gonna wanna watch it. OMG, I do. You do. Okay, I'm retweeting. Wait, when is the ad? Is it now or later? Is it happening? Because I don't want to retweet and then have people get an ad. Maybe I wait a bit. I think I should wait a bit. Pre-roll is on. Or off? I don't know, I'll wait a bit. I'm so excited for the vlog. Yeah, it's in my calendar to be posted tomorrow, because I'm supposed to have been editing it for the last few days. But again, I've been in my bed, so I'm not sure that's going to happen, but I will get up and edit tomorrow. So, calendar. Oh my god. Okay. Cool. I have 5 YouTube videos planned. And I actually have filmed 3 of them. So, maybe I'm awesome. Take your time since you've been sick. Yeah, but also how cool would it be? Story of my life. How cool would it be if I could do it? So I'm gonna edit it tomorrow. Realistically, I might get it out Sunday. Your sub ran out. Wait, so there is ads now? Or do you mean like free ads? I'm waiting for the ads to go so that I can retweet. But yeah. Oh, actually, no. Oh my God, can I stay on? Actually, no. Okay, right. Let me tell you the videos I've got planned. TwitchCon vlog, which will be this weekend, hopefully. Next week, week of outfits video, which was, yes, filmed a bajillion years ago, but whatever. Thank you, Milo, for the gifted sub. Collective haul, which is when I've just like filmed every time I've got. So it would just be like a haul of clothes I've bought, but over like the course of 2 months. And then those are all filmed. And then the ones I wanna do, how to find good clothes on Vinted. So it will be like, or eBay, which I need to workshop that title, obviously. But it's gonna be like more of a sit down video that I'll film on like how I find good clothes online using different tags and stuff, like search terms and whatever. And then maybe for that video, I'll buy some stuff to prove that you can like find good stuff. And then the other video that I've, the idea that I've had, which I don't know if I'm gonna do because if I'm cracking down on SBS, then I don't know how much time I'll have. But I had the idea, what if I, because I'm doing fashion related videos and I'm doing the Sims series. So what if I did a Sims fashion video and I did one of those kind of like challenge, like good on YouTube kind of videos, and I do the Sims 4 picks my outfits, or the Sims picks my outfits, or something like that. I need to work on that. But the concept would be, I like, it's like a challenge. Like, I do the randomized thing a certain number of times on my sim in The Sims. So it's kind of like, guys, watch The Sims series. Because we're in the between season 1 and season 2 of Smidge's Sims. And then whatever shows up on me, I have to use at least like 3 of those items in real life and try and make it work into an outfit that I'd actually wear, or something like that. Like, doesn't that sound like kind of good? But I would need to work out the logistics. And I think it would be like a YouTube video. Cause if I do it right, it could actually do quite well. Cause that sounds like a video someone else would do. Like, it sounds like a video that like an actual YouTuber would do. Do you know what I mean? Like, if I do a good thumbnail and like find out an actually good title and do like an intro that's like, hey guys, so today, I can do that. I can put it on. Smash that like button and make sure to subscribe. Something. Oh yeah. Oh, ad's over. Ad start in 3 minutes. Oh my god, we are, oh no, never mind. I was gonna say, oh, hype train is closed. No, it's not. Okay, anyway, back to the thing. Sorry, I'm keep getting distracted. I'm supposed to be doing a haul. We're still on day one. It's giving those eating like a sim for the day. Oh, there we go. Okay, I need to figure out a title that would look good, but yeah. And those would go out. So my idea is, because SBS was on Fridays, fashion videos will be Fridays. And if I, because the thing is, if my main channel is going to be gaming and fashion, I should stick to certain days being certain things. So Smidge's Sims was posted every Wednesday. So if I do fashion videos on Fridays and Sims on Wednesdays, if I ever reach a point where I can do two videos a week, or if there is a day, or if there is some weeks where I post two, then I have designated Sims days and fashion days. Guys, isn't my brain quite big? Like, that's quite clever. Yeah. But yeah, anyways, right, back to this. Well, that lingers. Blow up sticker, clip it! Game I want to play with Rosie or someone. Well, I mean Rosie, yeah, because she's like the expert. It's called The Pass Within. It's kind of like the bomb exploding game. But it's different a bit as well. It's really cool. I should play that with her. Leaflet from Blurp. They love me so bad. We went to their booth. And does anyone remember the Blurp guy from last year? Does anyone remember my story time of him? That we met him at the bar and then we showed up at the booth the next day. And I got a picture with him. And he's like 7 foot. Does anyone remember? Anyway. We went... Yes! We went to the booth and he was like, wait, I remember you guys. There we go. But I actually took this because they have, they added this thing. I'm actually Blurp's biggest fan. They added this thing where viewers can select an emote with a channel point thing and it will show up on the screen. So it's kind of like the sounds, but you can put an emote on the screen, which I think is cute. Even if, also animated. So I think that's cute, that's funny. Like, why not? Like, imagine you could put any emote on the screen. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I think that was the only thing I wanted to tell you about that. That's cool. I got given this. Also, not sure how this made it through security, but also maybe it's actually fine. But I'm pretty sure I should have declared this. I don't know. But it's a powder, and it's somehow a mojito. Mojito flavored. I mean, it's not actually alcohol. Gaming booster powder. It's caffeine and it's vegan. We should give this a go and see how fast my heart rate goes. I'll do that next stream. I think this is from this person that I followed on Twitter and they followed me back and that made me feel pretty awesome. Church. Matcha Woozy. I didn't realize, but a bunch of people follow them. But they had a new jeans print, which is really cute. So I bought it. And I bought loads of things from them. Well, I've lost the presentation. There it is. So much so that I got a free TwitchCon print, which is cool. Also, while I'm showing you this stuff, this is actually the last thing, so I can say it after this. Summer in Animal Crossing. Guys, how cute is that? So cute. Okay. What I was going to say is, I'm not 100% on this happening yet, but while I was shopping and everything, I realized how cute would it be if I had a booth? Like, if I had an Artist Alley booth. Because you can sell anything, right? And obviously, I don't draw. I'm not an artist. But imagine if there was a little Smidges booth and you could sign up to bundles there and I could sell merch in person and I could sell like customs, because the hypothetical birthday accessory mystery bags. I should be paying you guys. No one needs to see that. Mono, I should be paying you. Where is my phone? I need to write this down. Where did I just put it? Where is my... Oh, there it is. like clips and stuff.
Wow.
But the thing is, where would I be able to source that from, the accessories from, ethically? I guess I could just find a bunch of stuff from charity shops. Because I just imagined you guys opening a mystery bag and you being like, hold on, can't you buy a... Like, I don't want to be that one person that does a mystery bag and it's full of stuff that you can buy bulk on, like, AliExpress or something. Like, that would be awful. So I'm not going to do that. Anyway, but that's a good idea. And it would be really fun, I think. It would mean I would have to bring, like, checked luggage. And maybe put, like, the general vibe on each bag so people are more likely to get something they like. Yeah, that's true. But the only thing is I would need help with it. One, because I'm not good enough at maths. And two, people always say that you should have a helper with you when you run a booth. And also, it would mean that my TwitchCon experience is a little bit different. So, I mean, I think you can do single day things. If possible, I would go Saturday having a little booth and then Sunday as a goer. I don't know. Maybe I need to ask some people who are actually exhibitors there and be like, hey, what's up? But yeah. Okay, that was day one. We watched Doctor Who and went to bed. Cool. TwitchCon day two and the after party. Are you ready, guys? Oh, it's time to retweet now. It's Jingle Jangle time. But did I already do it? Oh God, I didn't. Yay, retweet. Life is awesome. Okay. Only bananas. Okay, I'm so ready, guys, guys, guys. We're on day two, we're on day two. Everybody wake up, woo! Also, great news. My auto-tune works. Woo!
Oh yeah. 360, winning when the man on the roof see. Life is awesome.
Anyway. Right, I'm gonna do date. What was that? Remix. I'm gonna do day two and then go to bed because I can't speak. Okay, although this could take another hour, who knows? Okay. I did even more shopping, which is a bunch of that stuff. I didn't separate them into days because I don't remember. And I went to my overdraft, which I don't have. So I was stressing a bit. And the following day, my rent leaves my account. So I was being a bit stupid, but what? I was just like, I wanna have fun, like it's fine. I'll get paid soon. But anyways, we met the person who's like in charge of the Hitman like socials and everything. Well, we didn't meet him. Rosie's friends with him, which is awesome. So I got the Hitman duck. Guys, look, it's Hitman. Apparently they're adding new content, so I should play it. I will play it at some point. Would you guys like more Hitman? Would you guys support a Hitman stream again? A good old Smidges Hitman. That's actually quite iconic, a Smidges Hitman stream. Oh yeah, okay. So do you remember how I was like, I've got a story of how I got this, wanted to know how I got this scar? Yeah, so the Hitman guy, his name's Combat Glue, by the way, he was giving out these badges and we were like, oh my God, we love Opera GX. And then he went, hold on 1 second. And he called someone and we were like, what? 5 seconds later, the Opera GX, like the act, the browser came up to us. He was wearing a red suit and an opera mask. And you want to, if you want to see what he looks like, you're going to have to watch the vlog. So we met Opera GX, like, it's him. It's actually him. Yeah. We, after TwitchCon, we left. Well, we did a lot of drinking, actually, at TwitchCon, but anyways. It was our last day. And we had gone to bed, like, at 10 p.m. every single day since then. So today, it was the day that we're going to party awesomely. Okay? Whatever that means. We watched the Euros. I'm stuttering. Okay, so we had a, this actually. Yo. We had an after party to go to. It was at this venue. So, but they were, the venue was also playing the Euros. So we decided in the gap between the end of TwitchCon and when the party started, we were like, we're just gonna go there. So we went, I'm gonna sneeze. Fun fact, if you do this, it stops you from sneezing. Awesome. Anyway, I had like the best bao buns ever. They were so yummy and they were like blue. I don't know why, but they were so yum. We watched the Euros. England won? Yeah, which was weird. Like, we were doing so badly. But that was crazy. I think we won. Or did we draw? I'm not sure. Well, we did well, I think. Oh yeah, and then the venue we were at became an after party. So we had fun, we had some drinks, there was music playing, but it was kind of dead. So we were like, we should go somewhere else. Okay. And so, oh, I got given a business card from a management company. Ooh! And so we were like, okay, we need to find a different one. Rosie found us a different after party. It was actually called the TwitchCon after party, which is crazy. And so we got an Uber there. We got tickets and we got an Uber there. And when we got in there, the first thing that I hear is Dan Clancy, DJ Clancy, the CEO of Twitch, singing his little heart out on the piano. Oh, what the hell? Okay. We get some drinks. Life is awesome. We're having a good time. There's people singing, there's people dancing. It was really funny. Put a sticker on me, okay. It was really funny because there was no one standing in front of the barrier. It was like a, imagine like a concert, like a mini concert venue. Does anyone, has anyone been to a mini gig at a pub? It looked like that. There was a bar, there was a stage with a barrier, and then like the cameras and stuff at the back. It was streamed, but they didn't save the VOD. So there's no evidence of this, minus a few videos that Rosie, I mean, that Meebs and Jude so graciously took of us. But no one was standing in front of the barrier. So we were like, Rosie was being like, is everyone just scared to move into the middle? Like, what's happening? And then slowly but surely everyone moved forwards. And I was like, I got barrier for the TwitchCon after party, woo! And I got some crazy footage of like, the CEO and whatever and everyone performing and stuff. It was really cute. And there was like proper lights and stage lights and everything, and there was like a little stage, and it was like, it was really cool and everything. And it was like for music people, so everyone there was like musically talented or whatever. So it was really cool to be like, hey, what instrument do you play? Oh, I play the drums. That's so cool. You play the piano? Wow, you know, whatever. And it was really awkward because I had to be like, oh, I don't actually, I'm not a music streamer, but I do play a lot of instruments. And every time I said that, people are like, why don't you? Hello? What do you mean? And I go, oh, well, I do it for like long streams to pass the time. Pass the time is crazy. But realistically, I don't know. I kind of like, I don't think that's going to change. I like what I do the way it is, but I do find it funny that, I actually could be a full-time music streamer, but I choose not to. But to be fair, I would get copyrighted so much, so never mind. But anyway, so there was that. Went there, so the teacher was singing, got some drinks. Oh yeah, I got some drinks and had some shots. I don't know how many I had, but somehow it was enough for Rosie to convince me to get up on the stage and perform. Now, I haven't performed in front of people since I was 17 years old. I haven't touched a live drum kit, because that thing over there, I don't know if you've noticed, but it's a small electric kit. And spatial awareness is very important when playing the drums, because if you miss a thing, you're going to hit yourself in the leg, and that hurts. That leaves really, really bad bruises, okay? And I was so drunk that I was like, do you know what? Yeah. But also, I wasn't even that drunk. I kind of was. But, okay, realistically, if I was sober, I wouldn't have done it. But I think it was just kind of like, do you know what? Why not? Because I love playing the drums, and the worst that can happen is I make a mistake, but, like, who cares? I don't know. Live drum kits can be scary. They can be. And I was like, yeah, sure, let's do it, whatever. So we signed up, and then also, so we signed up, but then what ended up happening, I'll tell you how like, it went down. So basically, after people performed, you waited at the side of the stage, and there were other people waiting to go up. And you would basically be like, while people were on stage, you would be like, what? So a song is ending, and we're standing there, and we're like, okay, we want to do it together. We're a duo. What instrument do you play? You play guitar? Okay, cool. Do you play bass? Okay, cool. We need a piano. Do you have to play piano? Okay, cool. Have you... okay, what song are we going to do? Do you know this song, Rosie? Do you guys know this song? No? Okay, well, if I give you the chords, you'll be able to play it. Yeah, I can play the song. I played the song for like 5 seconds to them, and they're like, okay, yeah, I think I could do it. Yeah, I kind of know the song. Cool. And then we're on the stage and we're performing. Like, I'm telling you, there was like no preparation. Like, I probably was familiarizing myself with the song once. Like, I played the song all the way through once on my phone while another act was on to be like, okay. And then we went up there and we played Forget You by CeeLo Green. It had to be the clean version because we had to be PG-13 or something. Forget You by CeeLo Green, and we played Valerie by, I've forgotten her name, Amy Winehouse. Oh, that was bad. It's her, right? I'm sorry, guys. I'm like delirious because I'm ill or something. Does that work? Anyway, so, and what's crazy for both of those songs is that I have to count them in. So it was like, but I did it, and I'm really proud of myself for doing it. And Rosie was incredible. She was really great. She like controlled the crowd. She was like having a good boogie and everything with the microphone. I mean, I could barely see, because this is what I love about being in a drum cage. If anyone saw the photo I posted on Twitter, I'm like surrounded by a cage. It's one, to keep the sound in because it's very loud and they have microphones for that reason. And two, because the lights, they reflect off the plastic, I actually can't see anyone in front of me. So it was good that I couldn't see the crowd, but also I couldn't see, like, I couldn't judge the opinions of everyone. Except, I guess, the cheering. But this is the one thing, I kind of wish I was a bit more sober, because then I would have remembered, like, people's reactions and stuff. I mean, I remembered the way that people came up to me after, but I wish I could remember exactly how it happened. But also, maybe the adrenaline is what made me forget it. I don't know. Anyway, so Forget You was clean sailing. I mean, I'm not gonna lie though, I didn't play it exactly how I used to. I kind of freeballed it. It was still good. It wasn't exactly how I want it to, but like, it's fine. I didn't make any mistakes, which is good. I just technically didn't play it exactly how I usually do, which is fine. It literally is no difference. But it was really funny. The reason why that happened is because I noticed halfway through the song that I was spaced out. What are you talking about? What do you mean? You are currently daydreaming while you are drumming on a stage in front of a crowd of people with strangers. I realized halfway through, like, it got to the bridge and I was like, oh my god, I'm not paying attention. Like, what do you mean? What do you mean? It's kind of like, I don't know if anyone drives. I don't drive, but this is what my dad says, it happens often. But while he's driving, he'll like realize he's driving and be like, oh my god, I wasn't paying attention, but like, he's still gone all the right ways and done the right turnings. Kind of like muscle memory, I guess. But it was really weird because how was I improvising, but I was like completely like a hello. I was like completely oblivious to what was going on for like the first half of the song. But that was cool. It's like walking into the kitchen to get food, not knowing you how you got there. Yeah, exactly. It's when I'm walking through places. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So I was like, I should lock in now. And then I did a cool ending. I was at the second one. For one of the endings, I did like an ending, and then I did a do-do-do-do-do-do. And I felt gasped by that one. I was like, oh, cool, I'll never do that right. Yeah, you did it right. Do you know what I mean? You know, when a drummer does a little thing at the end. And then the second song, we did Valerie, and I was like holding the song up to my ear, trying to get the... Because you know how Valerie starts? It goes... Well, sometimes... That came in at the wrong time. You get the point. Do you know... Yeah? So I listened to it, and I was like, okay. And I tried to... There's like a little bit of commotion between the songs so that we can figure stuff out, you know? So I was listening to it, and I was like, okay. And... In all fairness, I was drunk, okay? How many times am I going to mention this? Are we talking about the after party here? Yes! Yes, we are! And I started, like, trying to do the thing. I was so out of my mind, and also, I think, high on adrenaline, on the fact that I had just done the first song that was really good. So, I was, like, I was just, like, not... I mean, I was kind of getting it. It was like, instead of dunk 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 dunk, I was dunk dun 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 dun, which basically sounds the same thing. My kicks were just not in the right place, but it sounded pretty, like, fine, you know? Anyway, so we were just like, let's just do it and I'll play something. Because at the end of the day, I don't need to play the exact song. I don't need to be a carbon copy. Like, at the end of the day, the drum beat just needs to be in time. And realistically, the chords and the singer carry the song. I mean, I know there's some debate about that. The drummer kind of does hold the song together, but like, you're not gonna know the song from the drumming. You're gonna know the song from the chords and the singing. So I was like, I'm just gonna do whatever I can, and we're just gonna do it. Yeah, exactly. I don't need to do exactly the same thing. Like, it's just gonna be like the song, you know? So I was like, okay, fine, let's just do it. I'll play something. So I did a little intro. It was like dum ba dum ba dum, kind of something. And Rosie started singing, and I was like doing something, and I was like, oh, this doesn't sound, I'm not doing it right. It was like in time, but it just wasn't perfect. And then when we got to a bit where the beat changes, like I think it was like pre-chorus or verse or something, I don't know, I just started playing whatever I thought sounded okay. And I was like, I rarely do this because I kind of like feeling it instead, but I was actually counting at the beginning. I was like, okay, I need to lock in now. I'm gonna start counting. I was like, one, two, three, four, whatever. Pre-chorus, yeah, exactly. I just started playing whatever. And then so slowly it went like this. Like nerves or whatever. Nerves and playing the exact song. It was like this. Like straight down. Which actually, can we imagine it the other way around? Just so that it looks positive. So I slowly started moving away from the actual song, how you play it. And I started playing it like however I wanted to. And I think you could tell. I mean, I don't know. Maybe the crowd like couldn't tell because I was just playing whatever. I don't know. Because they were just listening to the song. Like there weren't, nobody's nitpicking. It's just me. But the more I played, whatever I wanted, I just improvised. I got way more comfortable. I was doing little fills. I was doing fun little, like I was hitting the cymbal before I even know I'm gonna hit the cymbal now. My hands were just playing and I was like, do-do-do-do-do. I'm pretty sure it was a vibe when you were on drums. Yes, sir. I was having so much fun. Yeah, so I was like doing my little thing. And Rosie did like a bell. Like I did like a, I was like, I actually don't know this part of the song, but I'm guessing this is a build-up of some sorts. So I was like, instead of doing like a fill or something, because I'd actually done a bit too many of those already, I was just like, dun 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 dun. And Rosie was like, wow, she did like a belt note or something, and I was like, hell yeah! Like, I wanted to stop drumming and be like, woo! But I realized I was the one drumming, so I was like, okay, no, I have to carry on. And then we did like a solid ending or something. Oh, I wish I remembered it properly. And I wish they saved the VOD. I wish they could... To be fair, maybe that's a blessing, though, that they didn't save the VOD. Because... Then I think I would watch it back and start anxiously being like, oh my god, everyone thought this. It's on YouTube?! Oh no. Oh my god, I found it. Oh my god. Reaction stream right now. Oh my god, I found it. Oh my god. Okay, wait, let me get this up. Oh my god, I'm so nervous. Okay, wait, I should probably tweet this out, right? Okay. Oh my god, okay, if I make a mistake, like, just, like, close your ears, basically. Where is it? Like 3 hours in. Oh my god. Trying to figure some stuff out right now. I don't know if I'm allowed to show this fan on stream because it has a swear word on it. That's Rosie! Oh my god. Yeah, that's true, actually. No one in the room was sober. And also, maybe that's why everyone was being so nice. No, I'm kidding. Can you hear that properly? What's that? Why can you not hear this properly? Okay, hold on. Let me fix this. Sound settings. Game? Oh my god, I didn't even know this conversation was happening. That's game, is it not? Why is it so quiet?
While we're also...
Oh my god. Oh my god, guys, I'm so nervous. Okay. Why is it doing that? Okay, here we are. Ba 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 da ba ba da. Okay, wait, I should probably ask Rosie first, right? I mean, I know it's on YouTube, but I think I should, right? That's like the nice thing to do. Let me quickly ask. Is she online? Listen to music while I do this. Yes, she is. Rosie, hi. Please reply! Rosie, wake up! Rosie, wake up! Rosie, wake up! Rosie, wake up! Also, hi everyone, I'm new here. Were you here? I have no memory of anyone I met, so if I met you, I'm really sorry. Hi, spying pair. Hello. I'm gonna ping. Wait, maybe I text her. Let me just FaceTime her, actually. Oh, I was added 11 minutes ago. How was TwitchCon? It was so good. We're about to watch me. Oh my god, I'm on 5%. What the hell? We're about to watch me at the after party. I want to be a nice friend first and make sure I get Rosie's permission. Um, Let me... Rosie. Oh my god, which Rosie? God, why do I have so many? Oh no, guys, she's not answering. I'm so scared. The little animals are so cute. These guys, Animal Crossing. Hell yeah. Is it really that wide? There's no way, right? There we go. Is this better? There we go. Oh my god, it is. It was widescreen. Okay. Well, there we go. Okay, right. I'm gonna wait a few more minutes. Oh my god, but I just want to be sure. What if I call her on her PC? Okay, if I'm... Wait, how do I do this? I'm gonna mute stream. Yay, okay, we can. Right, are you ready? Okay, if you're a professional lip reader, you would have just seen me saying, I love you, Rosie. Okay, right, everybody pose. We're gonna. Can everyone do the nails emote? Because I find that so funny. Wait, let's find a bit where I'm on state. Do they ever get close? Or is it just that? Okay, anyway, let's go. That's so funny, chat! Okay. Oh my god, I'm so nervous. I hope I sound all right. I mean, I'm okay. Wait, imagine I did hit the microphone during one of them, so I wonder how bad that's going to sound. And also, oh my god, I can't believe I did this. Also, I know for a fact that, I'm just gonna play it. There's no point in me stalling.
Getting some stuff done on stage. I'm just gonna take a step up. Moment.
This is us getting ready.
Is... Discussions are going on. If you play piano, the set list is open again. If you have opened the...
We do take a little bit long to get ready because I didn't realize that I actually had to count everyone in.
Venue, are we? Come on, venue, you can do.
Oh my god, look at my face, bro! Wait, let me. Because it doesn't really ever zoom in. I'm gonna do it like this. I think. Is that fair? That's fair. Guys, look. Look at me. Look at me. Enhance. Look at me.
Come Come on, venue, you can do better than that. Is this not the TwitchCon after party? That's better.
I'm scared. I forgot to poke owls.
I see you drive around town with the girl I love.
Oh, Rosie.
I'm like, fuck you. I guess the change in my pocket wasn't enough. I'm like, fuck you, and forget her to set it by.
Look, she can control a crowd. Like, she knows crowd work. Oh, she got told off for swearing.
Sorry, I can't afford a Ferrari. But that don't mean I can't get you there. I guess she's an Xbox. I'm more sorry.
I'm petting myself.
But the way you play your game ain't fair.
Okay. Look, there he is. This is the Twitch CEO in his cowboy hat. Oh, you can't see him. He won't pass. Oh, can we get that? Get a load of that Phil again, please. Who's Phil? Look, this is Jude and Meebs right here. She's still swearing. Oh, we made friends with these. Oh, you can't see them. Okay.
I had to borrow, beg and steal and lie and cheat.
Meeps is loving it.
Spending all with your rest in cheap. Now I can see the fool that falls in love with you, boy. Oh, she's a gold digger.
Cutting, cutting, cutting.
I got some news for you, boy. Oh, I really hate your ass right now. I see your job around town with the girl I love, and I'm like,
oh wait, you can't.
The
people over here are loving it. We like spoke to them a little bit and made friends with them. They're so sweet. I think one's from Ireland. These two, they're so sweet.
Still be with ya.
Okay, I don't remember this bit. Okay.
I tried to tell my mama, but she told me this is one for your dad.
Oh. Oh my god. Okay, wait.
This is one for your dad.
Okay.
I guess the pain in my chest. I still wish you the best.
You put the heart tune on now.
Fuck her too, I said.
If I was better, I'd still be with ya. What ain't that some shit? Ain't that some shit?
I get pain in my chest.
I still wish you the best. Fuck you.
I don't know this bit. Sorry, my phone locked. Fuck you.
Yeah. Look at me with the sticks in the back, bruh.
Sorry for all the swearing in that one. Please forgive me.
Aww. Wait, that was so funny. Wait, look at me, Mom. What? Sorry. Did I not just make the exact same sound that happens when you'd get cheers at Wii golfing? Hello? Does anyone know what I'm talking about? That sounded the exact same. Please tell me you know what I'm saying. I'm gonna sneeze. Okay, wait, I really want to find what I'm talking about now. Wii Golf. Cheering. I was still muted. That bit. Guys, that was actually me. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. At this point, look. You can look at me going to Meebs. Was I okay? Oh my God, look. Oh, wait, I love my friends. Look how cute. Look, watch Meebs and Jude. They were like, yes, you're so good. And I was like, oh, yay. Okay, I'm not going to do this beginning bit because this is just me figuring it out. Play.
Love. By Amy.
Wait, look at this bit. What did I just skip past?
The bassist. Is there any bassist in here who knows Valerie by Amy Winehouse? You!
That's Meebs.
Do you know the bass for Valerie by Amy Winehouse? No? What the hell? What the hell, man?
This sort of a song list.
Oh my God, Rosie dabbed! Rosie dabbed on stage! Did anyone see that? Someone please tell them to play the song. Look, this is them trying their hardest. They're so cute. I know. It's Slowey, my goat. Okay, look. Look. Like, everything but the kick is right. Do you see what I'm saying? But, like, it's still in the rhythm. It's just not dung, gudung, 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 dung. It's gudung, 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 dun. Yeah.
I don't know.
I was struggling, so we were just like, let's play.
Sorry. Anyone know where combat glue is?
Oh my God, I'm still figuring out. I didn't realize that took 10 minutes. Okay, the bassist needed to figure it out. Oh my God. Let's just get to the point where we start. Cause once we actually started, it was all right. I was just clearly having a, anyway. And I look across the water. Bear with me guys, please. It gets better. And I think of all the did anyone notice that just then though? I started a lot faster than Rosie singing, okay? So I'm going fast. And then she starts, I slow down. Okay, that's still pretty good. Even if I am like, I was going with the singer. I was improvising. You see, I was slowed down. I just decided to play what I want.
Stop making a fool out of me.
There we go.
Why don't you come on over, Valerie?
Yeah, okay. C. see, now I'm doing the little, I changed the symbol. I was like, I'm gonna. I shook it up a bit. Go. Lock in, please. Please. Oh my god. I love the crowd, like, enjoying it. Smidge, please. Please. Now is not the time to daydream. Is that the right chord? Oh my god, the smoke. Look, she's fanning the smoke.
My body's been a mess, and I miss your ginger hair.
This song's a bit slow. I kind of want to skip to the next bit. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, well, we're picking up the pace. Come on, let's go. I'm definitely gonna do this again next year. Guys, I want a live kit. I want a real one. It would be so loud. Why am I going quiet? Oh, I thought this was the bridge. See, I really don't know this song. But it's dynamic, guys, isn't it? It's creating movement in the song. Yeah, Rosie's getting it now. Yeah, there we go.
Miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you
come on over? Yeah? Then I'm picking it up. Yeah! Rosie! Down, 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 down. I just realized there's now video footage of the Twitch CEO hugging me and telling me he's proud of me. Wait, how do we do an ending? Oh, this is the bit. This is the bit. Rosie is so unbelievably cunt right now. It's crazy. I know, right? Wrap it up. Oh, do it again. Hit him again for me. Again. Okay. Oh my god, wait, look at my little arms at the end. Wait, I want to see how. No, wait. I'm like analyzing the crowd now. Oh my god, these people on the edge just went, that drama. I'm not gonna lie, after I did this, we stayed here for a bit. The next part, you move like a Muppets character. I think that's what Meep's dad said as well. After this, we went back to, we wanted to go to a club, but all the club, it's a Sunday. All the clubs are closed. And then we went back to the original place that we were at. Oh, we only played two songs. You're only allowed two songs. We went back to the original place we were at. Remember when we were watching the Euros? Because that was still a party. And they were playing music. And we were dancing and everything until the music got shut off. Again, because it's a Sunday. And then we got an Uber back to this place. We actually went back and forth 100 times. On my way out, bumped into Jack Manifold, which was crazy because I haven't seen him since Halloween. I was like, hey. He was like, hi. He was so drunk. And I was with Meebs, and he was like, oh, hi. And I'm not gonna lie, I was so drunk, I resisted every urge to go, oh my god, have you just shaved your head? And stroke his head, because it looked like a fresh trim, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, so that was cool. And then we went back here, and everyone was packing up. We had, like, missed everything. Well, no, we were there for quite a while, and we just went back to the other place for, like, what felt like half an hour, and then came back here. And they were packing up the music stuff, but we got one final drink. And then we walked Jude home. It's so odd that clubs close as... Exactly! There was nothing open on a Sunday at that time. I think it was like 2 a.m. as well. Last night... I don't know. Anyway, that was that.
Thank you guys so much. That was really, really great. Really great. The next part that we're going to open up while we just clear up a little bit of the stage is we're going to be reopening the...
Oh, I hugged the guitarist.
And we're looking for fools.
Yeah, he said, there's a few of them that said, yeah, you should do that professionally. I was like, huh? I can't read sheet music. I can't be a session musician. But it's fun.
Fools could make their way to the stage.
Okay, wait, let's see me go over to the Twitch CEO.
You are.
I spent a while talking to people.
You can even,
on the other side of the stage. Where am I?
From. I came here tonight. So scared of stairs. I'm stuck in. Well,
I'm not gonna lie though, it is quite daunting having like the live feed like from the microphones and not it's just like a recording because you will hear everything. But wait, stuck in the middle? Yeah, I think so.
But I can see a man. Cause I don't think I understood right.
Say the thing.
Yeah, I'm stuck in the middle of this.
There we go. Okay, wait, where am I? Go over to him. God, I really was talking for so long on the other side. Oh my god, there I am! I was waiting so patiently. There's Meebs. That's Rosie. Oh wait, how did I already speak to him? At that point? No, okay. Say the thing. I want to see it.
Você sabe como é ir e voltar quando você quiser.
Aww. Wait, that's so cute. You can see Jude being like, Rosie, I'm so proud of you. That was so good. I think the main thing, I just felt really, like, loved. That's so cringe. But, like... I actually didn't care that there was that many people in that room. I realistically didn't care that much. I know I did. What I cared about was, like, it felt like it was just Jude and Meebs watching. Do you know what I mean? Hello, hi. Oh my god. Wait, did I do it? Wait, I go over. What do I say? Oh, I was talking to the... Sorry, I went over here. I was talking to... Oh my god, wait! Let's zoom in over here. Guys, let's zoom in and enhance over here. I need... I took a picture of these guys' badges. I need to find them. But they were so nice to us.
Eu tive razão. Eu posso falar.
Não foi I don't know what I'm saying. Oh! Oh, I think this is where I took a picture of her badge. But they were both so nice. Guys, I socialized. Successfully. When do I talk to him? Did I miss it?
Welcome in.
Oh my god, this person took a really sick picture of Rosie. And everyone on stage.
I really wanted to play it for you, but I don't have a capo. But maybe go the capo first. If not, Canada. It's been fun. It's
go over to him, man. Have I missed? I might have gone past it. I'm not sure. Where? Am I there yet? I'm so short, I can't see anything. Oh, am I off camera? What a shame, man. I could have sworn it was right there. I'm gonna go back. Sorry, I know this is annoying. Okay, I'm gonna go back to it. And then, if I don't find it this time, then I will just... That will be it. Okay. And I'll go back to the story time. Let's zoom back in on here. Is this creepy? No, it's not, right? This is public. And it's me, so can't be.
Away. From home, enjoy the next people who want. How much?
And I showed him the screenshot of when he was in my chat. And I was like, I edit for Amy. And he was like, oh!
Brazil itself.
It's 5 seconds though, and I was definitely talking to him for more than 5 seconds. Is that it there? I'm there. I'm here. Did I imagine this conversation? No, I didn't. I said I did it. And he was like, oh, I'm proud of you. And then he hugged me. And I was like, what are you doing? Oh my God, maybe I imagined it. Or maybe I go off camera. I go off camera. But hey guys, it happened. It happened. Wow. What do you think, guys? What do you think? Do you have the coolest streamer ever? Do you? Do you? I think you do. Oh my God, it's Anne's birthday tomorrow. I'm not parasocial, it's just on Twitter. Anyway, okay, what else was left on the story time? Overheard where we were before, was busy, so we Ubered there, party till the music shut off. Ubered back. Thank you for the follow. Hello. Hi. The coolest streamer I am. Hi, Jude. We just watched the VOD of me performing. I was just saying earlier how it was really cute and in the least cringe way possible. I think that whole thing, and especially watching it back as well, it felt, what color are your eyes? They're green. I don't know if you can tell. It felt a lot like, oh my God, can I think, sorry. Watching it back, it felt like, I think, I genuinely thought that there was just you two in the room. Do you know what I mean? Like, I feel like watching it back, all I cared about was that I was performing to you two, which I think is so cute. And there's a bit in the VOD where, you can see me go, was I okay? And you guys are so loud that it picks up on the microphones, that Ewan Meebs go, yeah, yeah, right at the front. It was so cute. And there's a bit later where you can see you go to hug Rosie and be like, oh, I'm so proud of you. It's so cute. Wow. Smidge is the coolest streamer, we all say in unison. You are. I mean, I am. Hello. We were the only hype people in the room. To be fair, everyone was so drunk, but yeah, you really did bring the energy. And Rosie controlled the crowd as much as she could with the crowd that she had, but she was really giving it, which was really cute. Ubered back, bumped into Jack Manifold, music was over, packing up, bar still open, got one last drink, walked Jude home. Uber from Jude's. I sat on the pavement stressed because my rent left my account and I had -256 overdraft in a bank account with no overdraft. So I was like, I'm gonna die. I went to sleep and then I woke up and it was actually a glitch and the money was, I actually had enough. So I paid my rent, guys. Everything is fine. But yeah. But now I'm currently just like treading on eggshells, basically. So buy a bundle. Hey guys, did you know that you can buy a style bundle? Which means I buy you clothes and I can style you. And it's pretty awesome. Actually, wait, can you guys save up for August? Unless you're loaded. No, save up for August. Ignore everything I just said. Actually, wait. I need to do DVDs at some point. Should the DVDs just be with the birthday thing? Quickly before I end, because it's just us here. It's not really the same thing. I guess it kind of is, because it's styled by Smidge. And it's clothes. Maybe it's fine then? Because it would feel weird to do two separate drops, right? Would it be okay to, like, include them on the same thing? They're kind of the same. Either would be good, I think. That's true. I still don't know how much to make them. I mean, I don't know how much it's going to cost to make, but also I don't know if I should try and make it, like, exclusive. This is the problem I always have with making merch and stuff. I love things being exclusive, but I want more people having them. So that's the opposite of exclusive. But anyways, I still need to do like a poll for that, because if 10 people say they're interested, I will make 5 and I'll make them like a collector's item. So I'll put loads of effort in and then I can price it a little bit higher than like the CDs, for example, because the CDs were like £9. Because, I mean, it is a DVD. Do you guys even have stuff you can play DVDs on? Because I do, but my house is also ancient. Guys, buy a DVD player. Oh my god, someone buy a portable DVD player and then take a photo of them watching the SBS season 1 on a portable DVD player. That'd be so funny. Okay, I'm going to end because my voice is actually currently, like, it's dissipating. It is, oh my god, of course, Owen's doing a subathon. I was like, it's so crazy. I was talking to Ross earlier, and I was talking about everyone that, like, I bumped into at TwitchCon. I rarely saw Owen. I mean, I rarely saw a lot of people, but it's just, it's very busy. TwitchCon isn't really the place to meet up with people unless you're, like, going with them, so that's why, that's why I went with Muse and Rosie. Well, also because we're best friends. I was saying something. What was I saying to Ross? I was saying something about like going and seeing Owen, and then I was like, oh, I wonder if Owen is busy. And then Ross goes, well, he's just started his subathon, and I was like, God, I always do this. Always at the wrong time. Anyway, okay, we're gonna rate Owen. Enjoy his subathon. Give a sub because he's got cool things and he does cool stuff and he's awesome. He's got plushies out or something, I guess. Yeah. Go do that. Yep. Make him... Actually, don't sub because I want to see... No, I'm kidding. Do. Okay, I'll see you soon. Make sure you watch... Oh my god, we're streaming for 2 hours. Wow. Make sure you watch the previous vlog and there might be one tomorrow. Or Sunday. It's completely unedited, so let's just see. But I'm gonna wake up bright and early tomorrow and edit it. I'll see you soon. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye, all.